Of course, the first thing you need to think about when you build a campus like this, away from Paris, but at the same time part of Paris, you need to think, what are the qualities here that I cannot have in Paris? So that's the first thing you need to think about. And of course, this area has qualities because there's a lot of green, there's beautiful forest, etc. But at the same time, of course, the connection to Paris is still quite difficult because we are still awaiting the underground connection. And until that time, and also on the campus feeling, we need to be able, which is not easy, you need to actually think about creating a new city. But it's quite difficult, yeah? Because the most successful cities actually grow over time. This building is a piece of a city, but at the same time is of course a little city within a big city. So the big Saclay campus is of course very, very large. We had a super elect building, this is a new building, and we have a building next door. All those three buildings are oriented around the square. So all the students, together with the student housing, come together on that square over there. But of course this engineering school should connect much more than only to each other. They also have to connect to the remainder of the campus on the other side of the building. And that is why we came up with this diagonal route, because the idea is not that if you go over the campus that you necessarily go around the buildings, but of course it's interesting that people would go through the buildings, because then you really get also the city life. So the diagonal is actually an urban street through the building, connecting all the different facilities on the campus. The common spaces, we wanted to design it as a city. And what is important in a city is that you want to feel outdoor. And it's very difficult to create a space in a building where you can really feel outdoor. So what we did is actually we made a big roof, which you can see here over the building, made out of ETFE, which is actually a cushion made of plastic foils. And that material, as you can see, leaves the light through really one-to-one. So the color of the light is inside the same as outside. You know, what kind of spaces would you like to be in? So students, of course, want to be sometimes in the library in total quietness, but they also want to interact with each other. So that's why this building has different types of study places. We have, of course, in the center, we have the large restaurant with study places, which is probably the most loudest space where you can really feel the amount of students that are really studying in this building. It will be loud, it will feel like a city. And it's surrounded by more terraces where you can actually study and interact with other students and with your teachers in an informal way, but a little bit separated from the common space. And then behind there you have the really private spaces. And I'm gonna see in the 20th of September when all the students start in the building. I'm very curious how they're going to use the building, where they're going to sit, what they like, what they not like, how they're going to transform the spaces.